To fork the recipes repository, first I'll visit Larry's repository on GitHub. You can find the link for this repository in the instructor's notes. Now I'll zoom into this part of the page and click the fork button here. Then a copy of the repository is made on my own GitHub profile. Now, when I visit my profile, I can see the recipes repository here. Now, I'd like to be able to edit these recipes on my own computer rather than just on the GitHub website. So I'll also want to clone this fork. For recipes, it doesn't matter so much where I edit, but if I were writing code, I would definitely want to be able to edit on my own computer. The GitHub page contains the URL I should clone over here, so I'll copy that URL and paste it into my git clone command. Now I'll cd into the new repository, and you might think that I need to add the fork on GitHub as a remote so that I'll be able to push to it. But actually, when you clone a repository, Git automatically sets up a remote pointing to the repository you cloned from. I'll verify that by running git remote-v, and sure enough, there's a remote called origin, and the URL points to my repository on GitHub. Finally, since I want Sarah to be able to collaborate with me, she'll need permission to push to this repository. I'll add her as a collaborator by going to Settings, clicking Collaborators, and then adding her GitHub username, which is saladgel42. You won't need to add Sarah as a collaborator to your repository, but you can add anyone who you would like to be able to push to your repository. And then I'll need to click the Add Collaborator button. Now fork Larry's repository to your own GitHub profile. Don't fork the one on my profile, since I'll be making changes to my fork throughout this lesson, and you don't want those changes. Again, you can find the link to Larry's repository in the instructor's notes. Once you've created the fork, clone your fork, and run git remote-v and paste the output into this box.